Welcome, welcome, welcome. Nice Sunday afternoon art stream. Today we're gonna draw a spooky clown. You know, tomorrow is Halloween already. Can you believe it? I feel like the season just started. So this guy is kind of a clown with no body. Kind of like a head with legs, and then has some weird ass arms. I don't know if they're like robotic arms, or if they're bone arms, or if they're like spider legs. Kind of hard to say, but that's what we're looking at today. Little robot spider skeleton clown. Okay, I think he's pretty much ready to be inked. I think this guy today will just be a lot of easy shapes for me to ink, so that's good. Hopefully we can do it pretty fast. Man, I am so excited. After I'm done with this guy, I just have one more Halloween monster to draw, and then I will be free from Halloween. I can go back to drawing whatever I want. I still don't know what the last monster will be, though. So if anyone has any ideas, let me know. Got little clown cheeks. I'm just going to take the pen pressure off here so it'll just be one consistent width so I can do the mouth. Yeah, I think that'll work. Okay, now let me do the same thing for the arms here. I do want to pick something. Try this. Nope. I do want to pick something that is cleaner. That's a little cleaner, okay. I'm gonna see what game this is. Twilight Princess. The song is called Twilight. Okay, now I'll go back and erase these. You know what? What am I doing? Let me just trace over this, because otherwise this will be too hard. Oh, what's up, Chrisley? We have a... We have one of these, whatever you want to call this guy. A clown? Just a weird Halloween clown. Mechanical arms, spider arms, bone arms, who knows? Kind of a skull for a head. Pointy shoes, you know, regular scary clown. Still doing the inking right now. How are you doing today? You just finished your OC that you plan to turn into a VTuber? That is really cool. Wow. Man, I think it'd be so cool to have a VTuber model. Especially one you design yourself. The easy part is done. Gotta learn the rigging and stuff. Yeah. That stuff seems like it'd be pretty hard. Oh, what's up, Purple C? How you doing? Today we're doing a spooky clown type monster here. Very spooky. It'll be Hollow Pal number 19. Yeah, so this will be the second to last Hollow Pal for this year. And I'll still need to figure out what I want the last one to be. I don't plan these at all, I'm just like... Just like if I have an idea for a Halloween monster, I'll just draw it. And I don't like plan out what 10 I want to do, you know? So it's been a struggle to come up. It took me a few days to come up with this guy. Thank you. Man, although I'll miss the pre-Halloween season, I'm gonna be kind of glad when Halloween's over because I've been eating a lot of candy. Just, you know, to celebrate. But I gotta stop eating so much candy. When you're a kid and it's Halloween, you gotta go out and earn the candy, but when you're an adult, you just go to the store and you buy candy and you eat it. There's a basket of candies in my hallway and I haven't picked any yet, and I'm like, Well, tomorrow's Halloween. I'm excited to color this guy, but I don't know if he'll be mostly white and red, or if I'm gonna pick more Halloween colors like orange and something like purple or something like that. I guess we'll have to see, but I'm hoping I can get him a couple of really nice colors. I think no matter what I pick, as long as it's two colorful colors or white, I think he'll look like a clown. I really want his hair to be red, but I guess his hair doesn't really matter. As long as his hair is not white.
Okay, now we just need that other arm.
Oh, I gotta remember what I picked. This one? You know what? Actually, it doesn't matter because I'm gonna trace over it. I don't know why I keep forgetting that. Wheat looking very good. Man, this guy looks really cool. At least to me. I'm tooting my own horn here to myself. I love the way this guy looks. That'll be the lines layer. You can delete this layer and then make a lines copy layer to close some of the lines. Which lines? Okay, is this closed? That is already closed. Close that one there. Close these. And I believe that is it for closing lines. Okay, so I can go ahead and start coloring, which is super nice. Okay, this guy's got a lot of gaps in his silhouette. Or maybe just a couple. Or one, two, three? Three gaps? I think this guy will end up having a pretty nice silhouette. It's always cool to have a monster that you can recognize from the silhouette alone. Yeah, I think this guy's very recognizable just from the silhouette. Name that layer there. So, when I was drawing it, I was picturing it being white and red. But I think I should make it Halloween color, so maybe orange and purple? Are those Halloween enough? I don't really know what to name these, so I'll just... That'll be stripes one. And purple's like a Halloween color, right? Yeah, I think I'm definitely gonna have to change these colors. So these look like... It looks like a tracksuit to me. I don't know. Let's try red and yellow. It looks like Ronald McDonald, kind of. I'm gonna make the hair the same color as the first stripes. Hopefully, I don't regret that. Yeah, if I go with red and yellow, this is going to look like a McDonald's clown. We'll do red and white for now. The arms. What color should the arms be? I'm just picturing like an off-white, like a bone color. I was kind of picturing white when I drew them, but the gloves are white. And I typically don't like two things of the same color to be like touching. Ooh, actually, shoes, I don't know, red, I guess. What is a good shoe color for this guy? It's so funny when you draw something and you're picturing the colors in your head, and then you go to color it and you realize, like, it's not looking like you thought. Let me Google Halloween clown for a minute just to see. See some colors, see what comes up. Or maybe I should Google scary clown. Seen some red and white, some have a lot of black. Yeah, I don't really know. Here's one that's... So the stripe color would be red and yellow, and then the collar and the sleeves would be blue. So this guy doesn't have sleeves, but he does have a collar. Red nose, obviously. I think I gotta keep the hair red. A lot of these hairs are red. A lot of this is just Pennywise. What if I do purple and yellow? It doesn't really look like Halloween, man. We'll just call this layer white. We'll make the nose and the cheeks also red.
I'm just gonna add the hair to this. Okay, so I'm gonna start shading. If anybody has any color suggestions, you let me know. Because I do want to change these colors around. Yeah, I was thinking, what if I made him pumpkin colored, like his head is a pumpkin? Ooh, this I like. References for colors, maybe the Saggy, but Saggy the Dark Clown or Peeton the Dark Clown from Yu-Gi-Oh? Okay, let me look at those up. Saggy and Peeton. Okay, I've kind of got a picture of Saggy here. We will open that in a new tab and then Peeton. New tab. Okay. Okay, so I think this guy, he's either yellow and red or he's green and red. I can't really tell. He's got a cool mask, and then the other one, it's either blue or purple. Green and yellow? Oh, green and yellow. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, that's totally not red. Green and yellow, interesting. The other is blue plus dark blue, purple for hands and hat. Okay. Yeah, I wonder if I should change the hair to this clown. Green and yellow. That's not bad. Those are kind of like ball colors a little bit, not really, but. And then blue and dark blue and purple for the other one. Okay, let me try something. These are creepy colors. I don't really mind this at all. I kind of like this. Let me go back to red just to see what the hair would look like. Yeah, I kind of like this. Now, does this look like a spooky clown? Could you see this at Halloween? Kind of just want to make his hair the same as the blue. And then maybe this blue could be more of a purple. Yeah, I think I'll go with this for now. This looks really cool. Yeah, this combination of colors is a little off-putting, I think. I like it. Okay, I'm going to start by shading the white parts. I'm going to shade them with yellowish. Thank you. Okay, the white's all shaded. Now let's do the hair. Looking good so far, I think. Okay, let's shade the pants part of it now. This might give me a little bit of trouble. Thank you. Well, that won't work. Okay, I gotta go into the lines copy layer and make another line. I should probably just shade the whole leg in the background. I think I'll do that. Now that I went through all this trouble, I think I will do that. Okay, pretty good so far. Let us start shading the yellow stuff. Ooh, actually, should I start adding highlights to these? Thank you. Man, this guy's looking pretty cool so far. The playlist still going? Still going. Just gonna go to a different mix here.
Thank you.
Wait, yeah, those pants are looking really nice. Chat, if you've got some water, chug it. If you don't have any water, go get some. Well, I can see my wife walking my cat through the backyard. Our new cat who... She used to be an outside cat, so... She's on a leash right now in the backyard. Oh, that's cute. Yeah, I love this guy so far. Let's put some highlights on the yellow. Hey, what do I have left? Maybe just add the highlights and that's it? Oh, the red. I need to shoot the red stuff. And that layer is called what? Nose cheeks. Yeah, now let's add the highlights here. Highlights layer, so this will be a pure white layer to make things look a little shiny. Wow, you know what? I think I'm done. Yeah, I think I'm done. Cool. Well, here he is. Yeah, now all I have to do is think of a name, which will take me a few weeks, and then I'll post him. Anyway, thank you for joining me on the stream today. As always, I am thankful to everybody who watched. Look forward to seeing this guy in your Instagram or Twitter feed in the next couple of days. My next stream will probably be on Tuesday, and that will be my Halloween stream, I think. So maybe I'll wear a costume, who knows? Maybe I'll have spooky stuff all over the screen. We'll just have to see, but anyway, I'll see you guys next time. Bye! Thank you.